cell. So the bacterial cell is generally, it is prokaryotic cell. The prokaryotic cell have prominent cell wall. So the cell wall is made up of two to three layers of mucopolypeptides. Cell wall is rigid cell wall. It gives prominent shape and also it protects the bacterial cell. So inside of the cell membrane is present. The cell membrane is plasma, lipoproteinaceous cell wall is present, and also one side of the plasma membrane is folded inside. The structure is called as a mesosome. So this mesosome involve into the binary fission and also absorption. So the active absorption is shown by this mesosome structure. So this is the cell wall and this is cell membrane. So the cell membrane is made up of lipoproteins. And inside of it, the prominent genophore is present. The prominent genophore, that is nucleoid. So we said as genophore, this is a nucleic material, nucleic acid material. As well as along with this, the plasmid is present. Plasmid means extracellular chromosome, extranuclear chromosome. So it is double-stranded and also circular. Okay, so the number of plasmids are from species to species variated. Along with this, all the cell organelles are present. Cell organelles are present means 70s types of ribosomes are present. Ribosomes are present. Valutin granules are present. When you come to the external surface of the cell, few of the bacteria are covered by the slime layer. Slime layer. So the slime layer is, it is a protective layer and also it protect the bacteria from plasmolysis as well as dehydration. Okay, and negative bacteria, when you come to the gram-negative bacteria, it have the some external structures, hair-like structures, they are called pili. Pili, okay. So pili are present. So what are the function of pili? Means they are hair-like structure compared with the flagella. They are thin and small. They have the protein, that is pilin protein, and also they used for the absorption. Absorption means they, in the presence of the pili, they go and join to the host surface. Okay, and along with that, the plasellas are present. The plasella are present. According to the number of plasella, again the bacteria is classified into different ways. Okay, so the plasellas are present. So the plasella may be one or two plasellas are present. Okay, so it have the plasellin protein. The plasella do not follow the 9+2 arrangement. Okay, prokaryotic cell plasella. And another type of the structure also there, they are sexual pili. So the sexual pilis are compared with the pilis, they are larger than pilis. Okay, so these are the sexual pilis involved into the conjugation. So at the top, they one end of the side, they have the some pore like structures there. Through that the conjugation is going and the genetic material is transferred. It means transfer of genetic material has been conducted through the sexual pili. So here, according to the plasella, again the bacteria is divided into the many types. They are monotrichous. For example, if the bacteria having the one plasella, that is called monotrichous bacteria. Monotrichous bacteria. Next, amphitrichous bacteria. Amphitrichous bacteria means at two sides, two plasella are present. They are called as a amphitrichous. The bacteria is called as amphitrichous. And lophotrichous. Lophotrichous means two or more plasella are present at one end. Lophotrichous. another one is atrichus. Atrichus means absent of flagella. Atrichus, absent of flagella. Peritrichus. Peritrichus means throughout the body the flagellas are present. Peritrichus. So according to the presence of and number of flagellas, they are divided into the monotrichus, amphitrichus, lophotrichus, peritrichus. Okay, so monotrichus means one flagella only present. Amphitrichus means single flagella at two ends. Okay, lophotrichus means two or more flagellas present at one of the end of the point. And atrichus means here the flagella is completely absent. Peritrichus means number of flagella are present throughout the body. So like the bacteria is divided according to flagella, but you are coming to the cell of the bacterium. The cell of the bacteria is, it is prokaryotic cell structure. It shows the prokaryotic cell structure. It have the prominent cell wall. The cell wall is peptidoglycan, mucopeptides, okay, structured. And inside of it the cell membrane is present. It is lipoproteinaceous and one fold inside of the cytoplasm. So that is mesosome, that involved in the binary fission. Next here xenophore is present, that is the genetic material, and along with that the plastid is present. So here different types of the plastids are there. F factor, plastid is called as F factor. F factor is nothing but of F plastid. It means fertile, fertile plastid. Next R plastid. R plastid nothing but of resistant plastid, resistant plastid. And coal plastids also there. Coal plastid means it release the toxins. Okay, coal toxins. So the plastid that is responsible for production of the choline toxins, that's why they are, that is called as a coal factor or coal plastid. Like different plastids present into the different species, the number of plastids also based on to the number of species. But you are coming to the structure of the bacteria. So already we seen the structure of the bacteria and size and shape of the bacteria. So they do not in single size, some of the bacteria. It means some are present in spherical shape, some are present in comma shaped, some are present in spiralum shape, okay, rod shaped. But few of the bacteria can change their structures according to environmental changes and nutritional availability. Such type of bacteria are called pleomorphic bacteria. Pleomorphic bacteria means They change their structure according to the nutritional availability, according to the environmental condition. Such type of bacteria are called pleomorphic bacteria. Such phenomena is called pleomorphism.